All right, let's get warmed up, suckers. I always like to swing those arms. Can't move it. At least I did it. If you only knew how much equipment I had to move around. Oh my goodness. Those musicians. Such trouble. Let's do a goal post and go side to side. I like to put my arms straight out and just reach to the side. Just want to see who's all here today too, so I know. Gives me a really good idea what adaptations to do for you girls. Alright. You just pull one knee, the other knee. You can't do that, just get those legs moving. Stretch. Kick yourself in the butt. Boop. And row. Okay, let's do a warm-up. Alternative is just to stay on the floor. Okay? Alright, here we go. So we're gonna do a walk down into a plank and then do bird dog. Otherwise, you're just gonna go straight to the floor and start with bird dog. All right? Where to put my water? There we go. Always gotta wet that whistle in the beginning. Here we go. And begin. We're gonna walk down, or you just stay on the floor and do bird dog. You don't have to walk down. And reach, reach. Oh, this actually feels nice, the stretch. I'm actually reaching my hand, my foot, away from the center of my body. Stretching those muscles nice and long. Pretty good. An upper crunch, and if you can do a bicycle kick with that, do it. If you can't, you want to protect your neck, you're just going to do a bicycle crunch, or kick, sorry. And say you want to do just the upper body, just keep those legs up and crunch like this. So you put them all together, or you can pick the one part of it that works for you. Body doing core. It's kind of exciting. Oh, trying to hold those shoulders up while I do these kicks is a lot of fun. Alright. Go into seated position. You're going to roll down and decompress that spine going right to the shoulders, and then you have to come right back up. So, you can either take your hands and go right underneath your ankles and hold your feet like this, or you can just put your hands on the back of your legs. Here we go. Down, up. Down. Lift those hips, I'm going to do a pelvic tilt. So I'm pushing the hips towards my base, then I'm going to lift my hips up. Right. And now I'm going to do a walk. my feet, knees. One, two. And if you don't want to do that one, you could just do a glute bridge hold or glute bridges, okay? Can't do the walk. Otherwise, let's walk it up. Just do a glute bridge, you can do single leg glute bridges. Face feels dry. I need moisturizer. That feeling's dry. Make me want to live forever. There we go. Perfect. Okay. Roll up. Come to standing position. Stop that. Reset. All right. Here we go. In the water. Get ready for the bulk of the workout now. We start with a wall sit. The alternative is just stand in front of a chair, touch your bum on it, or you put that ball behind your back and do squats. And then the next one is a squat with one dumbbell on one side. So we're like working with our balance. And then we'll do squats with the dumbbell on the other side. Then we're going to do a reverse lunge. So if you like, let's say you wanted to just do everything on the floor. You could lie down, you could do clamshell on one side, clamshell on the other side, single leg glute bridge on one side, single leg glute bridge on the other side. That's the floor version, okay? So clamshell, right, left, single leg glute bridge, right, left, okay? So, make sure I got my dumbbell ready for the one part I wanted to do, but otherwise we're going to start with a wall sit. There we go. One wall sit, or you're doing your first clamshell, or if you want to do part of the standing, you could technically just tap your butt on a chair. Good times. I don't even know if I'm in the camera. Yep. I'll get it set up properly. It's my own fault. I should get up earlier. I thought I could pack everything up quicker than I did. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off. Boop. All right. Good job. Can you grab one dumbbell? I'm not gonna. You can do a shoulder thrust with your squat, but I learned my lesson. When my shoulders are tired, I am not doing that. Here we go. Rest. No thrust, right? Just squats, dumbbell on one side. Or you're doing the other clamshell, right? On squats today. 5, 3, 2, and 1. Good. I'm going to switch sides. So I'm going to put the dumbbell on the other side of my body. Yeah. I know now, after a big long rehearsal, cannot do overhead shoulder thrust. Right now my shoulder is weakened from playing bass. 5 hours. It's for that show I'm doing Friday at community center. Christmas party, all ages welcome. It's good for kids to experience live music. There's not a lot of opportunities these days for that. single lunge, reverse lunge, or you're doing a single leg glute bridge, right? So I'm gonna put the dumbbell on one side again. You could stay standing, do a donkey kick on one side too. Be so tired. All right, here we go. Over and over into a nice reverse lunge. Wow. Watch the balance. See, that's why I have one dumbbell on one side, for that very reason of balance. It's funny how adding weight just to one side of your body messes with your balance. Almost there. Got about 15 seconds. Then we're gonna go to the floor. Do a quick core blast and then do it again. Woo. 5 seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Good. Okay, let's go to the floor. You need one dumbbell. Have a sip of water. Giving us a minute to get there. Same idea as before, that first one. I want you to you have your feet up, together, lift that dumbbell to the laces and back down. Just do upper body. Or you can hold your shoulders up and do flutter kicks. Or keep your neck down and just do the front kicks. Okay, so that's your choices. We got about 15 seconds and then we'll start. So feel free to just be nice and relaxed, get that spine supported on the floor for now. We have about 10 seconds until we start. So one of three things you're gonna be doing, right? Upper body crunch, both, or flutter kicks alone. Here we go. So I'm gonna hold my shoulders up and flutter kicks. Our next movement is either going to be a Russian twist or a penguin based on your neck and lower back health. Lower back issues, you're going to want to do that penguin because it supports your lower back. And if you've got neck issues, you're going to want to do the Russian twist. Four, three, two, one. Good. So penguin, you would hold the dumbbell in your chest, lift up and go side to side with your torso. Russian twist, you're gonna hold that dumbbell in your chest and go side to side with your torso. You can even lift your feet up or you can keep it secure on the floor. Just want that nice 45 degree angle. Let's go. Almost there. 10. Five, four, three, two, one. Good. Back on your back. We're either going to do a heel tap. Here we go. Heel tap. Keeping that 90 degree angle. Or you can just do an upper body one and run that dumbbell up to your knees and back down. Here we go. So there's your choices. Dumbbell up the knees. Do the upper part or lower body. Tapping those heels alternately. Staying on the floor and doing the clamshells and the glute bridges. That's what we're doing next again. Otherwise, we're going to do a wall sit and squats. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, get on that wall. Otherwise, you're doing clamshell, side one. And then, basic glute bridges for one of them in between. Technically there's 5 movements, right? A double time. 10 seconds.
Give me a moment of clarity.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Okay. Here we go. Clamshell side two. Or let's do some squats. Dumbbell on one side. Here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Ooh. I'm trying to push through my heels, not my toes. Now you're going to do a double leg glute bridges. Then you're going to switch to single leg glute bridges. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Go. Ah. That bum down, chest up. Trying to keep my balance. Sip of water, and we're doing, you're on the floor, you're doing single leg glute bridge on one side. If you're standing, you're doing a reverse lunge. One side. Or you can just face that wall. Drop your kick behind you. One side. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. One dumbbell on one side. Whoops. See? As soon as I turn my head, there goes the balance. 10 seconds. seconds. 7. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Switching sides. Hey. Alright. Great. 2. 1. Let's go. Other side.
Lights down low. You and I.
How you get a nice butt. Me.
Take me to another dimension tonight.
Yay! Hey, you got 1 minute. Go back to the floor for core. You got time. So drink water. Reflect. Alright, so remember that flutter kick. And you had that upper body hold. Now, you guys are just upper body crunch with the dumbbell, keeping your legs straight up or down. And, or you can just do flutter kick. Or you can do both. You can do holding the shoulders up while you kick. In about 20 seconds, I'm going to get to work. You can have a little bit of a rest. Ready? 15 seconds. Almost there. All that open window goes down. Here we go. So, I'm going to hold my shoulders up off the floor as I flutter kick. Remember, you just do one or the combo. It's the one that works best for you. You're not going to be wanting to do the upper body crunch with that neck or shoulder issue. If you got hip or knee, you're probably not going to be wanting to do the flutter kick. You're just going to hold those legs still while you do the upper body up and down. Here we go. 15 seconds. Going into either penguin or the Russian twist. Four, three, two, one, good. Feet down. So, doing penguin, you hold the dumbbell on your chest and you turn your torso side to side. Russian twist. You might be able to get seated position. Use your heels, but I want you to have a bit of a 45 degree angle. Torso side to side, you are not moving the dumbbell. Pushed into the floor. And try not to change the 90 degree angle in the back of that knee. Full control.
Yeah.
time. We'll start a bit late, so I'm trying to get us moving here. So, either stay on the floor, get ready for your clamshells, or let's do a wall sit. Reset my timer. Okay, here we go. Wall sit or clamshell side A. 2, 1.
How does it feel when your walls fall down? How does it feel when your love stand found? How does it feel? It's the sweetest sound. How does it feel? I can feel my body burning.
Ooh, my legs love this. Next one is the squat with the dumbbell on one side, or are you doing clamshell side? Side B clamshell or a squat with the dumbbell on one side. Here we Side B for the squats. Here we go. Rah. Reverse lunge or a single leg loop bridge. Little wall, donkey kick. Here we go, siding. Reverse lunge. When you're doing this, you want to step straight back. Sometimes people think you're supposed to do a lunge like your feet are on a tightrope, but really it's like you're standing on a train track. Other side. 3. And begin. Take your time. Focus on form. After all, it was a high rep situation. Almost there. 10 seconds. Woo! Home stretch. What? Yeah. My palm strips are done. Alright. We're gonna hit the floor. Home stretch round. If you're not already on the floor. Here we go. Let's just go right into those flutter kicks with the upper body lift, or you're doing one of them, right? By now you should know which one you're doing. Ah, so sweaty.
Your heart is so alive. I'm angels so again.
Sometimes when I do something like this, I push my heels towards the ceiling. Really stretch those calves while I'm doing this flutter kick. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, good. Russian twist or a penguin. It's a goal. Can you dance? Or senores. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Side, side. Running that dumbbell up to your knees. Those are your choices. Here we go. Keep that lower back into the floor. Belly button down. Pushing that belly button down towards the floor. Like someone's got a string and they're pulling your belly button from behind towards the floor. So protect your lower back and work your tummy. That bend in my knee, like I'm a Barbie bent. Well, later on Barbie, because the knees didn't bend in the beginning. Top leg and straighten the bottom one. So now my knee's on the floor. And then I'm doing my goalpost position. I'm gonna lie back and just let gravity stretch that shoulder. And it's the thoracic spine will really stretch it as well. A little bit of both. After playing by holding my base for many hours, it's really nice. Yeah, that post I did, there's a QR code. If you click on that, pulls up the QR code, then guess what? You get free tickets to that thing. Alright, let's go. On the side. Knees, hips parallel. Pulling that bottom leg straight. Pulling the knee to the floor, goal post, and lies and hold it part of my spine, my thoracic spine was way tighter. That sure felt bad. My elbow should be on the floor. That's how I know.
Can you feel me?
knees. Down to your back. One knee to your chest. I got my right knee here, so that we move along. I'm going to do ankle circles. Oh, I got my knee up there.
Can you feel it? Let's get it on and on and on. Can you feel it?
I'm going to try and pull this right knee towards my left shoulder.
Back
a bit. Hug my left knee and straighten my right leg out. And I grab my left knee, see if I can't pull it towards that right shoulder. Center and do those ankle circles on the other side. Both knees to my chest. Hug my knees. Side to side again. Both my feet out front. Okay. Right leg comes up. And I'm going to just cross it right over my left leg and hug it to my chest. And then my right hand, because this is my right leg, is going to go behind me and I'm going to twist my body. Back forward, I'm going to see if I can't just lay that knee on the other knee, which, yeah, right, tight, and then just hover forward a bit. Sorry, hip, don't be so mad. For some reason, this doesn't work for you. You could just put both your feet forward and hinge forward and stretch the back of those legs. Straighten both legs out, put your hands on the floor, and work as far forward as you can go. Watch, you can try to touch those toes. Get my left leg up, put it on the outside of that right leg, hug it to my chest. Body behind me. Stand behind me and look behind me. Stretching that thoracic spine and the hip at the same time. When we're lying down, we're stretching our shoulder and thoracic. Now we're doing the bottom half. It's like we're wringing ourselves out. And then if you can do this comfortably, try, attempt to bring that knee down and lie it on the other leg. And then hinge forward. If you want, you can hold. You really feel a big pull in the back of that leg. And if you can't do this, you're going to go both your feet forward. Back. Do that right now. Both feet forward. Hands on the floor, other side of my leg. And just roll forward. Try to take a deep breath in. And roll forward as I breathe out.